as one, Crookshank, your one and only Move Swiftly speaker, checking in for a daily Move Swiftly thought, giving you a perspective on teamwork that you will not get anywhere else. Thought I was through talking about this, man. I thought I was through, you know, addressing the D-Wade statue, but I have to come on. I have to come on and give some further detailed thoughts. Before I say anything else, just know, all right, you're speaking to someone, you're listening to someone that has been on the receiving end on a ton of different roast sessions, all right? I've been on the receiving end on more than I've been on the, you know, giving out, throwing jokes out there and stuff like that. I've more so been on the receiving end of roast sessions. And one of the things, you pick up a few things. You learn a lot about people when it comes to, you know, what they're willing to talk about, the just the audacity and the how ridiculous some people actually are to have the nerve. And one thing that you got to understand, now listen, again, I get it, I might be a little biased, I'm a huge D-Wade fan, was a huge fan of his as a player growing up. He was one of the guys that really looked up to when I was a kid and I was in that phase of life. All right, so again, maybe a little biased when I'm saying this, but listen, you want to get at him with the fingernail polish and the painting the fingernails, hey, have at it. You know, that's fun and games, and that's something me personally, I can't necessarily defend a whole lot, because that's something I don't really understand. But it isn't for me to understand. He doesn't live his life. You understand, this is a guy that literally has fuck you money. He has fuck you money to the point where he can care less about what you may say about him, you know, with fingernail polish and what he wants to maybe do with his daughter and his wife and all that kind of stuff. But when it comes to this statue, all right, when it comes to this statue, until you have a statue, until you personally, I'm talking to you personally, which 99% of you guys listening to me do not, until you actually have a statue outside of an arena, until you are actually a Hall of Fame, if you're not a Hall of Fame or a person that has a statue of themselves, you do not get to talk shit. All right, you do not get to take part in this roast session until you actually have a statue yourself. Now, if it's Jordan, on that note, if it's Jordan or it's Barkley, it's one of them cats, one of them Hall of Fame cats that, you know, been there, done that, has accomplished the things that D-Wade has, even them, I feel like it's still very, very, very irresponsible for them to come out and publicly talk about D-Wade's statue the way they've talked about it, because now you've given people permission to talk about it who have no business even given any input whatsoever on the way a statue should look. You know, shoot the guy, you guys know him personally, probably shoot the guy a text, you know, give him some shit a little bit about, you know, hey, the statue doesn't look like you, but do that privately and don't do it publicly, because ultimately what you're doing, how irresponsible that becomes when you look at things from the grand scheme of things and understand kids are seeing this and young people are looking up to it, looking up to you, are feeding into all this stuff. You give credence and you give permission to the trolls who haven't done anything, haven't played the game, only critics. You give them permission to start doing the same. And that to me is very irresponsible, seeing that, you know, we're in a time now where, you know, Donald Trump's supposed to be the divisive one. Donald Trump's the one that's supposed to, or Kamala Harris, the people that are in politics are the ones that are quote unquote creating the division within our own society. But it's you guys, the same his peers, that are coming out and, you know, giving them shit publicly about the statue. Now, like I said, again, if you know him personally, you know, shoot him a text, shoot him something private, you know, have a little fun with him or whatever. But don't allow that to be the story. Don't allow that to be the headline, the thing that makes news. In fact, let me break you down. Let me explain something to you guys. All right, let me explain. It's a college story, that is going to clearly explain the roast session rules. All right, roast session rules, very clearly and explain. All right, so there was a time I was in college. Shout out to my boy Taj, man, we gotta catch up, man. We gotta catch up for sure, man. So it was this time where it was my boy Taj. It was Taj and Sticks. Sticks was actually another receiver on the team. And I remember it was one night, I didn't go out, but I was, you know, we used to hang out in the dorm and all that kind of stuff. And I remember one night they had came back. I think they came back from a party or somewhere they went. And I remember just like laughing, like uncontrollable laughter as they were coming in the dorm. And the two of them, Taj and Sticks, were in the middle of a roast session. Like a roast session, you know, they kind of talking about each other's outfit or whatever it is. And they were boys, you know, they knew it was all fun and games, whatever. But they were hanging and, you know, again, had a pretty intense roast session, and there was an individual there who was just laughing at everything. And Here's what happened. What you saw and you looked at what this individual, and I'm not going to put his name out there, but when you saw what he was wearing, when you saw what he looked like from the shoes to the shirt, everything, it was like, yo, okay, bro, you know, you laughing a little too hard. There's certain qualifications. If you're going to be like, if you're going to be laughing like that, you might have to, you know, slow that down. There's certain things, there's certain rules when it comes to roast session, meaning if you are looking like you're looking, you don't get to laugh, brother. You don't get to laugh. If you go, because they were kind of going at each other's outfit or whatever. And he goes, if you have your outfit on, you don't get to laugh. You can maybe smirk here and there and kind of make yourself quiet, but you don't get to uncontrollably laugh the way you're laughing, because eventually we're going to start to kind of look at you and see what you got on. And then it can get really bad for you tonight. It can get really bad. And it almost did. It actually almost did. The thing is, they were kind of done going on each other, and then they started to look at him. And that's when he actually got a text, and he got out the room quick. In my opinion, he strategically got out the room because he knew what was about to go down. So the point of me explaining that to you guys is, again, if you don't have a statue, if you have, there's nobody talking about you having a statue outside the arena, you don't know now. And I don't want to hear any comparison to the Kobe situation. Understand, unfortunately, Kobe is no longer with us. And he couldn't take part in building the statue. D-Wade was a part of the whole thing, and he was clear, he was on record saying, hey, look, I stood behind it, I knew exactly what was going on. Out here in Miami and South Florida, we have some weather, so there were certain things that I had to educate myself on to maybe make sure it looks like that. And they were, you know, with me throughout the step-by-step process. And you have these fucking idiots on TV talking about, you know, having the audacity to make fun of it when you don't know him personally. Again, I don't have a problem if you want to get at him with the nail polish and, you know, you want to have a little fun there. But when it comes to his statue, when it comes to his legacy, when it comes to everything he's done for the franchise, all you're doing is creating a very divisive energy. And ultimately what you're doing is just hating. It's just plain and simple. No other words to describe it. It's simply hating. And I'll close you out with this phrase. I remember hearing this. It was Kirk Cousins. Kirk Cousins said this, I think, on one of the Netflix documentaries. He goes, if your haters see you walking on water, they're going to only say it's because you can't swim. Think about that, all right? All that being said, tap in with me on the live streams every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Sundays as well. Eventually, I'm gonna make it a regular thing where I'm jumping on live streams regularly. I'm enjoying them. I'm having fun, man. It's gonna be a great, great end. Let's have a great ending. You know, let's start to really pick it up. Have a great ending to this new year and really hit this thing hard, man. Main website to check out to dive deeper into all my work, though, it's makeyourmove.com. It's makeyyamove.com. One stop shop for your teamwork and your self development needs. As one Crookshank and one and only Move Swiftly speaker checking out. You guys continue to move swiftly. We will talk more soon.